Yeah, I don't believe in destiny. I just do what's best for me. Don't listen to my enemies, they're just full of jealousy. Yeah, this legacy, you gon' see what's left of me. You gon' see success in me. You ain't seen the rest of me. I just wanna be the best at what I know, better than the rest. Just
hi everyone, welcome to my talking script. Today, I want to talk about something that's very important: depression and loneliness. We all know that it's not easy to be alone, but when we feel depressed, it can be overwhelming to realize that we are not alone in this feeling. Depression and loneliness can often go hand in hand, and it's important to address both of these feelings in order to get better. Being alone doesn't make you sad or depressed, but the way you feel about yourself when you're alone can. When you feel like you don't belong, when you feel like no one understands you or wants to be with you, those feelings can become toxic and amplify your sense of loneliness. But remember, you are not alone. You are not alone in your feelings of depression or loneliness. One of the best ways to combat loneliness is to seek support. It can be as simple as reaching out to a friend or family member, joining a support group, or even reaching out to a mental health professional. Sometimes, talking to someone about your feelings can help you feel less alone and more understood. Another important step in overcoming loneliness is to focus on your own self-care. This can include things like exercise, eating well, getting enough sleep, and taking time to do things you enjoy. When you take care of yourself, you are better equipped to handle the challenges of life, and this can help you feel less lonely and more connected to the world around you. Remember, you are not alone. Depression and loneliness can be overwhelming, but seeking support and taking care of yourself can help you feel better. Remember that you are not alone, and there is always someone who wants the best for you. So don't be sad, you are not alone. Hi there. I'm here to talk about something that's been on my mind a lot lately. It's something I feel many of us can relate to: the pressure to lie, to tell a story that isn't entirely true just to fit in, to make ourselves seem better or safer. I know that it's not always easy to speak up and say things the way they are, but when we do, we need to remember that we aren't alone. We all have insecurities, fears, and biases that can impact the way we perceive the world around us. And when we try to avoid these things by lying, we create a false sense of safety that can be harmful to ourselves and others. But it's not just about avoiding negative consequences. Lying can also be toxic to our relationships. It undermines trust, erodes communication, and can lead to misunderstandings and conflicts. And when we lie to others, we're essentially saying that we don't trust them either, which can be an invitation to mistrust and conflict. So, how do we break this cycle? How do we say the truth, even when it might not be easy? Well, for starters, we need to be honest with ourselves. We need to ask ourselves what our biases and assumptions are, and how they might be influencing the way we see the world. We need to be willing to listen to others, to validate their experiences, and to be open to learning from them. And when we do make a mistake, when we do lie, we need to be willing to own up to it and apologize. We need to be transparent and honest about why we did it, and how we can make it better moving forward. It's not always easy, but it's the right thing to do. So, I don't lie. I wasn't talking about you. I was talking about everyone. Because when we stand up for ourselves, when we speak honestly, and when we work together to build trust and understanding, we can create a world that's safer, healthier, and more just for everyone. Hi there, today I want to talk about loneliness and how it can feel like we are alone in the world. It's okay to feel lonely from time to time, and it's something that most of us will experience at some point in our lives. But what makes it different when we feel lonely for long periods of time, and how do we cope with it? It can feel like we are not alone when we feel lonely. Every human being feels lonely from time to time. It is natural and expected, and it doesn't define who we are as a person. But when we let our loneliness consume us, it can have a significant impact on our mental and physical health. Loneliness can increase feelings of anxiety, depression, and even suicide. It's important to recognize that loneliness is not something that just happens to us, and we have control over how we feel about it. One way to cope with loneliness is to reach out to friends or family. Talking to someone about our feelings can help us feel less alone and can provide us with emotional support. We can also try joining a social group or community that aligns with our interests. Being part of a group can provide us with the sense of belonging and connection that we may be missing. Another way to cope with loneliness is to engage in activities that bring us joy and fulfillment. Whether it's reading a book, going for a walk, or working on a hobby, engaging in activities that we enjoy can help us feel more connected to the world around us. Remember, loneliness is not something that defines us as a person. It is something that we can experience, and it is okay to ask for help when we need it. If we feel that we are alone and disconnected from others, we should not hesitate to reach out for support. It may be as simple as talking to a friend or joining a group that aligns with our interests. Sometimes, all we need is a little bit of love and attention. Hello everyone, today I want to talk about something that is very important to all of us, love and respect. Love and respect are the foundation of any healthy relationship, and they are essential for our personal growth and well-being. Love is a powerful force that can bring people together and create a sense of closeness and connection. It is the feeling of warmth and affection that we feel for someone or something, and it is a fundamental need that every human being needs to feel fulfilled. Respect, on the other hand, is the acknowledgement and appreciation of someone's unique qualities, thoughts, and feelings. It is the willingness to listen to someone and take their perspective into account, and it is the foundation of any healthy relationship. In today's world, we often forget to show love and respect to those around us. We may criticize, judge, or criticize others without giving them a chance to defend themselves. This can lead to feelings of isolation, loneliness, and low self-esteem. It is important to remember that we all deserve love and respect, regardless of our age, gender, race, or any other characteristic. We should treat each other with kindness, empathy, and understanding, and we should strive to create a safe and inclusive environment where everyone feels valued and heard. In conclusion, I want to encourage everyone to practice love and respect in their daily lives. It is a small but meaningful action that can have a huge impact on the people around us. Let's show kindness, empathy, and understanding to everyone we meet, and let's create a world where love and respect are the norm. Thank you. Hey guys, today I want to talk about something that's been on my mind a lot lately. It's common to feel like you have to work hard in order to succeed. I know I used to feel that way, but I've come to realize that it's not good for your health. In fact, working too hard can actually do more harm than good. When we put too much pressure on ourselves to perform, we run the risk of burnout. Burnout is a physical and emotional state that can manifest in a variety of ways, including irritability, anxiety, and depression. When we feel like we're constantly struggling to keep up, it's easy to let down our guard and become overwhelmed by life's little challenges. But the good news is that there are ways to work smarter, not harder. One of the best ways to avoid burnout is to prioritize self-care. This means taking breaks when you need them, practicing mindfulness, and engaging in activities that bring you joy. It's also important to set realistic goals and to celebrate your successes along the way. Another key to avoiding burnout is to focus on your strengths. Instead of trying to be everything to everyone, focus on your strengths and leverage them to achieve your goals. For example, if you have a strong work ethic, use it to your advantage by pushing yourself to be more productive and efficient. But if you're more of a people person, focus on building relationships and collaborating with others instead. In summary, working hard isn't always the best way to succeed. It's important to find a balance between hard work and self-care, and to focus on your strengths rather than your weaknesses. By doing so, you'll be able to thrive in both your personal and professional life, and avoid the risk of burnout. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you next time. Hello everyone. I want to talk about something very important to me, and that is the concept of being strong. Being strong is not about being a superhero or having superpowers. Being strong is about being able to handle difficult situations and challenges head-on, without getting upset or losing your cool. We all face difficult situations in our lives, whether it's personal or professional. We may lose someone we love, face financial struggles, or deal with health issues. It's important to remember that it's not your fault, and that you are not alone. There are people out there who love and support you, and who will help you through any obstacle. Sometimes, we may feel like we can't handle the pressure. We may feel like we're not good enough, or like we're not who we should be. But it's important to remember that you are who you are, and that you're beautiful just the way you are. Don't let anyone change you, or tell you that you can't be who you want to be. Be strong, and don't let anyone make you feel like you don't belong. You are loved and valued just the way you are, and you are worth fighting for. Remember that you are strong, and that you can overcome any obstacle that comes your way. So, take a deep breath, and remember that you are strong. You are capable of handling any situation, and you can overcome any challenge. Believe in yourself, and don't let anyone bring you down. Stay true to yourself, and be yourself. Because you are who you are, and you are amazing. Thank you for listening, and I hope this message has touched your heart in some way. Let us know what you think in the comments below.
I don't believe in destiny, I just do what's best for me. Don't listen to my enemies, they're just full of jealousy. This legacy, you gon' see what's left of me. You gon' see success in me, you ain't seen the rest of me. I just wanna be the best at what I know, better than the rest.